Welcome back. I know that some of us were here last Christmas. This might be for some of us our last Christmas as parents of a child of Chisholm Trail Academy. And so tonight we want to celebrate the birth of Christ, but also music and sound. We want to thank all the parents who have made the sacrifice of putting their child at Chisholm Trail Academy, as well as those parents who drive endless hours to drop off and to pick up their children. So as we begin, let us bow our heads to ask the Lord's blessing. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for what a wonderful evening that we can celebrate and remember your birth. Not only your birth, but the purpose of this season, God. We know that Christmas can be boggled down with all the other things, but Lord, tonight we just want to focus in on your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, we know that he came down to this earth not only as a baby, but as a Savior. And Lord, we want to lift his name on high this evening, and we want to sing, and we want to reminisce in this moment. Lord, help us to cherish this memory. For some of us as parents, this is our last Christmas program at Chisholm Trail Academy. For others, this is the very first of many. So we thank you so much for the ministry of our friend, Mr. Wilcox, and all the students who have put a lot of time and effort into this program. We thank you so much for Chisholm Trail Academy. In Jesus' name. Amen.
anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn and provide for those who grieve in Zion, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair.
Thank you.
Comfort. 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 Comfort my people, says your God. Comfort. Comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her hard service has been completed, that her sin has been paid for, that she has received from the Lord's hand a double for all her sins. Behold, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all mankind together will see it. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel. Who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by man, a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering. Like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely, who took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted. He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother, Mary, was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. After he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own hometown to register. Joseph also went up to Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Oh,
All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. Praise be to the Father, to God, the Lord of our Jesus Christ, and his great mercy. He has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade. once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. When the kindness and love of God, our Savior, appeared, he saved us, not because of righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy.
Thank you. said wise men.
Oh, they traveled afar.
Said wise men.
And they followed a star.
Said wise men.
And the journey's end in that little town of Bethlehem.
Look beyond her there, see the star of glory. Star of glory. Star of glory. Look beyond her there, see the star of glory. Shining down on Bethlehem.
I said angels. What a heavenly sight.
See him in our state.
For the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Would you stand with us in prayer? Gracious Father in heaven, this afternoon we've been reminded anew that God so loved the world that he gave us, his one and only Son. Today we say thank you for this greatest gift, the gift of hope, the gift of salvation, the gift of Jesus. May he be born in each one of our hearts anew during these special days and weeks. And then may we choose to be reborn in him every day. Thank you for all you do for us, but most of all, thank you for these wonderful young people who have sung from their hearts the messages of hope and grace and mercy and Jesus. Bless them, each one, and bless each one here tonight throughout these special holiday seasons. Keep us in your care. Bless us to be more like you, for it's in the wonderful, holy, powerful, saving name of the Christ child, our Savior. Amen.